Right. So in this lecture, let's concentrate on drag and drop functionality. Let me take over you to that demo first before we automate that code. There are times in your app where you need to drag something and drop into that specific location. Okay. So after clicking on this views, there is something called drag and drop. So here, you see that, if you read that, it says long press on a dot to start a drag and then drop over another dot. So manually, you need to long press on this and slowly you can drag this and drop out here. Okay, so that's the functionality. And how can you automate that? Let's see. It's so simple. And such kind of similar scenario we have already covered in one of the test cases, and I'll show you that. Let me create one more class saying new, and it's drag drop demo. Okay, so as usual, I would see that how much time I'm saying just by copying this capability step. So if not, for every test case, I need to go and define all those capability steps, you know, this one. So for every test case, I need to write this. So apart from that, I just written in one file and I'm inheriting into all my files. Extends base. Add close declaration. Perfect. So again, the first step is a common word for us to click on that views. Let me click on that views. So thereafter, I need to click on drag and drop. Take a screenshot. And drag and drop. Yep, this is the text. Take the text from here and place it. Cool. So after I click on the drag and drop, and the manually I need to long press to pull this, right? So all this press, long press, tap, move to, that all these touch actions can be performed using touch action class, which we have seen in our previous lectures. New touch action, pass in driver argument, import java.client, T dot, first of all, you need to, so what's our man, first of all, note down what you are doing manually. And as I said in my previous lecture, replicate same into automation. You need to long press
and release. That's it. So it's just a normal action. Drag, you can drag from your any of your destination. Okay, let me drag again, and you can drop out of any of these four circles. Maybe I can drop here in my second circle. Okay, so just we will interpret this manual steps into our automation. So what all we have seen manually? We have long pressed. Right? And then we moved to the second object and released it there, right? Long press. You need not long press for a few seconds and you can skip the duration. Move, release into destination. So long press on your source object, move to your destination and release it there. That's all we are doing, right? Okay. So let's write an Appium automation script to replicate same. T dot you know. By now you should have familiar about how to work with that. Long press. So I can go with this long press. Okay, long press options dot, and you have to import one package which you can take from your swipe. Okay, so here is a long press options. It's very simple. You know what? So only challenge in Appium is the infrastructure setup. Once everything is set up and once script started working, and the core automation with Appium methods is very, very easy. It's all about 5 to 6 methods you will keep on using for complete automation of your app. Okay, so that's what you're seeing right here. We have swiped, we have scrolled, drag and drop, and all the gestures we were able to do with simple touch action class. Or if you want to click, if you want to get text, any one thing, you are just using find element by XPath, find element by ID, find element by class name. Okay, so all our automation scripts are rotating in 5 to 6 methods. Okay, that's all Appium does for us. So everyone says that infrastructure setup is a challenge for Appium. Once everything is set up and once base program started working, and thereafter, it's a cakewalk to learn this tool. Yeah, so long press options dot with on which element you want to long press, you have to provide here. So that will be like element of web element, right? So this web element now we have to define here. Web element source from where you have to drag. Driver dot find element, and let's go and take the object of it. So this is my UI automator and this is my emulator. Let me take the screenshot and that will give me the access to all the objects of the page. Okay, so select this and you have resource ID. I think this is a unique. Let me put it aside. Yeah, and if you select this, maximize this. So drag.1, drag.2, you have unique IDs. But problem here is you have a semicolon and slash, which are special characters. You can use that by escaping that special characters by introducing one more character, but better let's take another locator because we have so many locators available, right? You need not depend only on ID. You can still use ID, which is unique, but there are some special characters, right? That could lead us to again put some special character to escape that character, which makes that object more complicated, and I'm not sure if Appium really identifies it. In earlier versions, you know, it leads to break when we provide special characters with escape character. So when I say special character, it's slash. This is a really a special character if you want to put it in string. All right, that's fine. Let me take class. What's wrong? So if you go back to my one of my lecture, I think it's basics. We have seen n number of ways to identify an object in the app. Isn't it? We have seen ID, XPath, class name, and we have seen UI, Android UI automator. You can use any of it. Okay. So I will go with a class name, but problem here is class name is same for both the objects. If you watch carefully, class name is android.view.view. And if you go and spy on this, and again, it's same class. That's fine. Let's do with an index. Okay, first we will bring find elements to get all the class elements of the page, and then through index we will identify every object here uniquely. Okay, so driver dot find elements of class name. When I say get of 0, I will get this, and when I say get of 1, I'll get this. Okay, let's do that. So where is our test? Drag and drop. Okay. So let's go with the class name, by dot class name, and you provide dot of get of 0. Out there are multiple objects will be written, right? When I say find elements, okay, because we are trying to extract all the items present in the page with the class name. So driver dot find elements by dot class name get of 0. From out of all elements, I am asking to pull the 0th index, right? And I have to drop that in my first index, which is our destination. So this is our web element. Perfect. Okay, so source is here. I would say, sorry. And for the element also you have to import. So this is a package for element. All right. So we are long pressing here on this element. After that, let's move to destination. Okay, so that's what we need to do, right? Just to cross check, long press and move to destination. And here move to, you can skip this part. You can just directly give element of web element, which is destination. Okay, so what we have done, I have long pressed, I have moved. What is the next step? Release. Okay, once you long press and move it to your destination, you should release it, right? To place that there. Okay, so I will say dot release. And what is the mandatory step you need to perform for touch action to execute this in a sequence? Dot perform. That's it. That's all you need to do to drag and drop. This drag and drop is, you know, commonly used in every app just to make sure if this is properly working. And that's it. So this is what you do manually, and this is how you replicate through your automation code. Okay, so let me tell you one shortcut. So this step you have right here, you can skip this part, but it's better to write like this. But I have seen their official documentation of Appium, and they are saying that you can simply write like this. You see that? Just like how you are doing for move to element of web element, you can also do long press element of web element instead of this step. Long press option start with element. Okay, so use this if you are not having any additional step. Okay, when I say additional step, after giving with element, if you want to hold on for few seconds, again you have to say dot with duration, wait for few seconds, and again dot if you want to click on specific position. Okay, so if you want to perform multiple actions on one single long press, then you have to write like this. But if you say that I just want to long press and that's all I need to use from long press, then you can skip this part. You can write just like how I have written here, element of web element. Element of web element dot move to element of web element. That's it. Okay. In our previous session, we have given like this because I am using one more action called duration. After long pressing, I'm asking to wait. So to support all these options, we have to write like this. But if you don't have any, if you have only this element of web element instead of and nothing else, then you can simply wrap like this. Just like how we have done for this. Okay, it's just a tip, and that's what they provided in. They did not explicitly provide in any official documentation, but from the examples what they provided, I understand that this works like that. Okay, so what do you want? Let me comment this. Let's use this step, element of web element, move to release start perform. All right, so let's run this test and see how it goes. So right click. Okay, I think my Eclipse is hanged. Give me a second and that would be back. So it happens. So you have Android Studio open, emulator open, Eclipse and my recording software. So many softwares. So that will get our system performance low for sure. So what happened? It's trying to run. Yep. So I'll go back and open the studio to see the logs. It's not yet started. Checking whether app is present. Yep. So it unlocked the app. So I just restarted my system. That's why it's again loading everything and trying to run. So it opened the app and it's trying to click on wheels and drag and drop. It did not drag. I think that's why. I'm so sorry. I just copy pasted but forgot to change the index. So here I have moved from source index and I'm still placing it on source index only. Okay. I have given the same locators in source and destination. I hope you guys have identified this, but just because this is online lecture, you did not interrupt me and to ask this to change. All right. So now I have changed to one. So you will clearly see that it's dragging down. So let me run this test. So this time you should see that. And I think you are building enough confidence on Appium by the lectures, what all you have watched till now. And you can start Googling for interview questions and start preparing for your interviews. Okay, it clicked on waves, drag and drop. Yep. You see that, how it's moving? It's like eclipse, right? It's like solar eclipse or lunar eclipse. I'm not sure. But it has slowly dragged and dropped in our destination part. Okay, so that's how you can work with drag and drop with Appium. Okay, and as I said, start preparing for interviews. This knowledge is enough to start kicking your Appium automation. So no one is really mastered in this Appium. Okay, so the knowledge what you have gained till now is enough to just say confident that you have worked. There's still a lot more that you will see how to run this in real devices, iOS framework. There's still a lot of stuff there, but core stuff, you are almost there. Okay, and this core stuff is enough to face the interview with confidence. Okay, I'm just saying that you will build the confidence with the lectures what you are learning by now. All right, so if you need anything, you can email me or feel free to Google and learn on your own. Anything is fine. So ultimately, learning concept is your key thing here, okay, which we are doing in the form of lectures. All right, guys, hope you have got clear information on how to drag and drop. We'll see with one more topic in our next lecture. Thank you.